Today we will discuss the new chapter and the first chapter of chemistry, that is some basic concept of chemistry. But before that, we will know what is chemistry. You have already studied in class 10th what is science, but we will discuss now what is chemistry.
The question is that, what is chemistry?
We know in chemistry what we study. In chemistry we study the first one, chemical composition. We study about the matter, that what is the chemical composition of the matter, what is its structure, and what is its property. In property we relate both the physical property together with the chemical property. It means in chemistry we deal with this information of a matter. What is that one?
The first one is the chemical composition. The next one, we discuss chemical composition, structure. And the next one, property. In property, we will discuss both properties. The one is physical property. And the next one is chemical property.
Chemical composition, what it means? Chemical composition, it means what is the content of the matter? What is the content of the matter? Let us focus here. For example, if we discuss about the water, water is composed of H2O. It means, chemical composition means, when, if we are discussing the chemical composition of water, then what we see here, when hydrogen combined with oxygen, in the proportion of 1:8 of their masses, we know. The next one, if we discuss about its structure, we know the structure of water as this. This is the microscopic property. If we discuss about the bulk, we know water has hydrogen bonding. It occurs in solid, liquid and gaseous state at various temperature and pressure. It means in chemistry, in chemical composition, we discuss what is the content of the matter. The next one, structure, it means how the atoms and the molecules are arranged to give the entire structure. And to the next one, property, we discuss about the physical property and the chemical property. Physical property and the chemical property, let us discuss the first one, physical property. We know what is physical property. It means a property which we observe during the physical change. You know what is the physical change? Physical change, it means a change in which no new substance is being formed. For example, if we melt ice, on melting ice, the composition of ice is H2O and the composition of liquid state is H2O. What the change has occurred? It is converted from solid to liquid state. But during this melting, what we observe? We observe melting point. It means melting point is a kind of physical property. Clear? It means, once more, physical property means
the property which we observe during the physical change. What is physical change? Physical change, it means a change in which no new substance is being formed. Clear? When we discuss about the chemical property means what is its nature, such as whether it is acidic, basic, what is its other chemical behavior. It means the property which we observe during the chemical change is termed as chemical property. The next, we know while dealing with the chemical composition, structure and property, we deals with how we discuss the structure. We discuss the structure on the basis of arrangement of atoms and molecules. You also know the chemical changes and the physical changes can be observed at a bulk level as a result of arrangements of atoms and molecules. That's why chemistry is also known as the science of atoms or molecules. Once more, we see the chemical composition. We are going to define the chemical composition on the basis of atoms and the molecules. Structure. In order to understand the structure, we will discuss what is the arrangement of atoms or molecule to give them that structure. Property, we know if we are discussing the chemical property together with the physical property, we are discussing that we know that during chemical property, the bonds, old bonds between the atoms are broken down and new bonds are formed. What it means? It means we are going to relate all the phenomena of chemistry with the help of atoms and molecules. That's why we can say it is also known as the science of atom and molecule. Clear? Next to that, we will discuss why to study chemistry. What is the importance of chemistry in our day-to-day life? We know, most of you know what is the uses of chemistry, but we will discuss it. Importance of chemistry. We know chemistry is very important to us. It is also attached with the other branches of science, such as biology, physics, and so on. But why to study chemistry? The question is that in order to understand the various phenomena, such as in order to understand the functioning of brain, in order to understand the weather patterns, temperature, pressure, and so many other things, in order to know how to prepare various material which is used in our daily life, such as soaps, detergents, polymer, plastic, semiconductor, ceramics, and the most important, we know pharmaceutical, that is the drug. It means why to study the chemistry? The reason is that the first one, to understand the functioning of body. The next one, body, weather patterns. The next one, it helps us to prepare various material used in our daily life, such as, you know, the first one is soaps. So, let us discuss is a dental soap. The next one, cosmetic, powder, creams. The next one, polymers. In polymers, we know we have fabrics, plastic, Teflon, PET, biodegradable polymer, nylon, nylon 66. They have a wide variety of application in our daily life. The next one, polymer. The next one, nutrients, drugs. Drugs, we will discuss two drugs. The first one is cisplatin. And the next one, Taxol. These are used in cancer therapy. What is the structure of cisplatin? It is CT, CL, CL, NH2, NH2. Cis, clear? Cisplatin, Taxol, it is used in cancer therapy. The next one, AZP, that is azido-thymidine. Azido-thymidine, it is used to treat AIDS. The next one, what we know, by the use of chemistry, we know how to substitute chlorofluorocarbon. We know the chlorofluorocarbon, these are ozone depleting substances which depletes the ozone layer, due to which the harmful ultraviolet radiations reaches to our surface, which is quite harmful to us. It means by the use of knowledge of chemistry, we can replace, substitute the chlorofluorocarbon. The next is that, by the use of knowledge of chemistry, we can substitute various harmful chemicals. The next, chemistry helps us to prepare polymer, semiconductor devices, semiconducting material. To the next, chemistry also helps us to know the weather patterns. How to know? We know the global warming, because we know the automobile exhaust, the gases that is methane and carbon dioxide. These are the prominent greenhouse gases. We will discuss about the carbon dioxide, because its concentration is higher. It forms a layer around the earth's surface and traps the heat radiation, lead to increase in the temperature of the globe and known as global warming. In this way, by the means of knowledge of chemistry, we know the weather patterns, we will prepare the material of our requirement, desired requirement. It means what we have studied, chemistry helps us to understand the weather patterns, biological phenomena. The next one, it helps us to prepare various material used in our daily life, such as soaps, detergents, cosmetic, fibers, plastics, fibers. The next one, drugs. We have discussed two important drugs, three, cisplatin, Taxol, used in cancer therapy. And the next one is FT, used for treating the AIDS bacteria. We have also discussed that by the use of knowledge of chemistry, we can prepare semiconductors, we can prepare ceramics, we can prepare other material of our desired requirement. To the next, we have discussed the knowledge of chemistry. By the use of knowledge of chemistry, we know that the automobile exhaust contain various greenhouse gases, which is result for global warming. Clear? To the next, we will discuss about the nature of matter. In class 9, we have already discussed what is matter. You know, anything in this world which has two characteristics, that is, it has mass and it occupies space. If it has these two characteristics, then it is termed as matter. For example, pen, it has mass, it occupies space. Book, it has mass, it occupies space. We have mass, we occupy space. Table, chair, books, whatever it has mass and occupies space is known as matter. Then you have a question in your mind that what is not matter? Then I will give you one example, that is the thoughts, views. The best example you have, the energy, sunlight, heat. It hasn't mass and it will not occupy space. Then we categorize it as non-matter. Let us discuss what is matter. Matter means anything that has mass, and the next one occupy space. If it has two characteristics, then it is known as matter. For example, air. You know, air has mass, it occupies space. Air, chalk, pen, book, etc. We have a wide variety of examples. To the next, we will discuss based on the physical state. What is the physical state of the matter? It is categorized into three types. You know, based on the physical state of matter. Is categorized into, you know, matter. It is categorized into solid. The next one, liquid. And the next one, gas. Clear? Let us discuss solid, liquid, and gas. Solid, we know, in case of solid, it has we have studied in class 9 that it has fixed mass and fixed volume. But in case of liquid, you know, in case of liquid, it has fixed volume, but not fixed shape. It has fixed volume, but not fixed shape. The next, in case of gases, it has not fifth volume, not fifth. See?
Why it is so?
We will discuss the reason.
We know in case of solid state, the molecules are compactly packed.
It has fixed mass, fixed volume and fixed shape.
So the next, in case of solid state,
the molecules are compactly packed.
If the molecules are compactly packed, it means they have least intermolecular space.
The molecules are compactly packed, or they have least intermolecular space.
If they have least intermolecular space, then they have strong force of attraction in between them.
The next is that they have strong intermolecular force of attraction. Then they have strong intermolecular force of attraction.
If they have strong intermolecular force of attraction, then they will not have random motion. It means they will not move randomly, but they are fixed, their molecules are fixed at a definite position, and they will have only and only vibration motion.
The next is that their molecule have not random motion, and are fixed at a definite position.
Whether they have not motion, they have, but which motion? They have only and only vibration motion. It means they will move with their along their mean position.
They have only vibration